development has become a sort of a universal panacea for various social problems. I think that partners participating in this project felt a strong need to come together and discuss what community development practice really is and how can we arrive at a point where we have a common understanding, a common background, a common tradition, more or less, or common values for the work that we are doing.
So essentially and fundamentally, community development is about working to create the conditions for a more just, equal, sustainable and inclusive society by people engaging in collective action to transform their lives.
Community development actually has as a purpose to make sure that everyone can have his basic rights. That's a very broad purpose, but in a democracy it should be like that, that people have some basic rights as housing, as education, as work, as, you know, being part of a society.
What I see community development trying to do is to combine the different aspects of community life and to bring people together, different communities together in order to take action and action be how do you say, the drivers in their own life. What community development does is not only to develop these individual communities, but how can you build a net and a cooperation between different communities?
We would certainly say very much about working with people who are disadvantaged or excluded or marginalised, so it's not a general strategy. It's about working with communities, whether they're in poorer neighbourhoods, but also we will work with communities of interest, as we call them, disabled people or black and ethnic minority people.
What we hope for is that citizens will start to claim their role in public matters and they will start actively to be involved in making decisions and also taking role in implementing of those decisions. So basically they will become active members of the community.
Point is that when we do something on the local level, we have to have in mind that there is a global dimension. If we want to change our society, we cannot ignore that there is a crisis, structural, systematic crisis, which is global, which is not local. So we can change the bank in my town or in my city. But if we don't change the whole system, it doesn't change anything.
So for me in community development, there's a couple of core values that I think are really important. One of them, and a fundamental one, I think, is the idea and concern that people should have a say on the issues that affect them and that communities as a whole should have a greater say and influence on the circumstances of their own lives. And the reality in the world that we live in and the Europe that we're a part of, that many communities have very little say on those decisions and very little access to or influence in relation to decisions that are made by others about them.
I think that diversity is what defines a community anyway. We are all different in our own ways. And inclusion is also about diversity. It's about recognizing the differences between people and accepting that we are different and that we see things differently, we perceive things differently.
And it's really to believe that every human being has a competence and how can you bridge and make a dialogue between the expert's knowledge, the theoretical knowledge, and the competences and the knowledge that are embedded in our life experiences.
Respect to the people that you work with and learning one from each other. Because still a lot of people, both like social workers but also policy makers, are coming from the position of being experts who knows what should be done about the others. I think really that wisdom has different dimensions and learning and knowledge is something which is not owned by the experts.
I think the main ones that are important to me are accountability and democracy and empowerment so that people can actually express something that's important to them. And I think probably the overriding value we would say is equalities, because we're always conscious of which communities, which groups are getting less of a deal than others, and what can be done to support them to have more of a say, more of an influence, be more heard and be more included.
Community development is a process. We use it to try and stimulate people's initiatives. People basically have a lot of ideas and energy. Perhaps they don't know how to channel them.
There must be a way of working which people can relate to without being saying we are part of any political party, any organization, just that we want to work for more just and fair society and for people who want to make change together with other people.
Community development comes as a frame to help people become aware of what their needs are, what produces the problems that they are facing, analyze how they could change things for the better.
Act as midwives for people who need to organize themselves into social action from their situation. Not to be the advocate for the people, but to be their helper in terms of organizing.
The community development and community workers, community process should be just straightening the skills and the talents of the people that they can better act together. And so they can solve a very simple problems, but they can also influence the policy.
There are several methods, and these methods are changing from time to time. They can come into fashion. But there are a lot of methods for community planning, for example, and also a few for evaluation. But it's important that these methods stick to the values of community development.
And essentially, I think probably what's important is that in community development, that the tool doesn't become dominant, but that the tool is anything and everything that you might use in order to work towards achieving the overall purpose and linking that to the process in which we're engaged with.
The changes in community development might be seen sometimes as small. Because of the way how we work, first we try to find something really concrete and really small to make a change and to be sure that we can make a change on that. But most of the time, the change that is made has a structural meaning, which means that it stays for a longer period. We want to make changes only if they fit for a collective, for a group of people. So it's not that you change a situation of one person in one area, but that you made a change that is like long-lasting and for a lot of people.
We are concerned with outcomes, and if we are investing in community development, then we should be looking at trying to see outcomes across different levels. Outcomes that are visible and evident at the level of the community itself, outcomes that are visible and evident at the level of policy and legislation, and beyond that again, outcomes that are visible and evident in how the thinking or ideology about different groups of people has shifted over time.
You can find many, many examples of well-run, well-organised community organisations doing good stuff in their communities. And people will say, yes, people's lives are better, they feel much more connected, they feel much more involved in things. And things have changed by way of housing or the environment, which are a benefit to those communities.
I know we have saved millions and millions of public money by organizing people, helping them to become members of organizations, getting help and to work together. But most important, that I think we have made life a little bit better for some people in our society.